The heavens are telling the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day to day, pause for speech, and night to night, declares God. Once more, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to What Do You Know? The second quarterfinal set in the 2020 championship is what we're dealing with this afternoon. The contestants are individuals who are knowledgeable, and they are, moreover, veterans. They will introduce themselves.
John Awuni, a native of Zobiga in the Fusga district in the Upper East region and an Akali town based.
Paul Afari Minta, Letton Safari, work with the senior high school, don't call nothing.
Aminu Hussein, Community 1, Chema.
Yeah, good man, together, and welcome the contestants. Ladies and gentlemen, these are the men who are competing for our next this afternoon, the second quarterfinal set in the 2020 championship. Ladies and gentlemen, the competition starts in earnest. Round one, question one. Now, listen, religion is a social control system. A sociocultural system of designated behaviors and practices, norms, worldviews, texts, sanctified places, prophecies, ethics, organization that relates humanity to the supernatural, to the transcendental and spiritual elements. Religion is a broad-based institution. In which religion would you find the following? Duvali, Dushira, and Holi. For the avoidance of doubt, spelling Duvali, D-U-V-A-L-I, Dushira, D-U-S-H-I-R-A, and Holi, H-O-L-I.
Krishna.
In which religion would you find these as religious days? Which religion? Yes, Babu?
Judaism.
You've eliminated one religion.
Judaism.
You eliminated another religion. There's so many religions. Don!
Shintoism.
You've eliminated one.
Hinduism.
Hinduism! Hinduism. But you see, Safari, let me take you to the Bible. This is a peculiar case, and people have not taken notice of that fact, that there is only one woman in the Bible whose age, you know, women would normally are very reluctant, you know, in providing their ages, and so. So you don't normally identify women with age. So in the Bible, there is only one woman whose age was provided. The others, their ages were concealed.
Is it Anna?
No! Come again!
What about Sarah?
Sarah is the father! But you see, so the Sarah concept is what I will dwell upon now. If Sarah's age was declared, how old, according to Genesis 23:1, was Sarah? What age was declared there?
90 years.
Not 90.
70.
Sorry. Yes. Chibu.
105.
No. John.
120.
Paul.
Is it 95?
127. 127.
That's right.
127. Now, is it? Are you ready? Now, a prescription drug or prescription medicine is a pharmaceutical drug that legally requires a medical prescription to be dispensed. Prescription. What does the Latin expression
Tinye in die on a prescription meaning. Tinye tie in die. T-I-E-E-I-N die D-I-E tie in die.
Daily.
Not exactly. Come again.
Once a day.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Jibu.
Follow the rules.
Yes, John.
Taking after meals.
Tia India. Paul, what do you think?
Three times a day.
Three times a day! Tia India. So, that is the precise Latinic delivery of the issue. The Latinic, you know, the definition of the whole thing. Three times a day. Hmm? Three times. Well, normally the drugs are taken three times. So take it tier in the air. You understand? Paul, I am of Italian origin. I lived in the period 1655 to 1731. I was unsatisfied at a time by the lack of control that a group of professionals had over the volume level of the harpsichord. I was credited for switching out the plucking mechanism with a hammer to create the modern piano around the year 1700. So you see, the prefecture message is mysterious, in its beginning, but as it unfolds, you realize, you know, the issue is clear. Create the modern piano around 1700. Who am I?
The person is called piano.
The person will not accept piano for his name.
Michelangelo.
Piano forte. Remember, piano forte. And you?
Forte.
Yes, Kweru.
Frederick Douglass.
Sorry?
Frederick Douglass.
Finally, Don.
Nicola Pagnini.
Well, your name, you know,
or Pagnini.
Circularizes somehow with the name at stake, but I'm afraid Bartolomeo Cristofori, you see, yours was what?
Nicola.
Nicolo, you understand, it's rhymic somehow. Bartolomeo Cristofori. Huh? Cristofori. Cristofori. You understand? So, unless you want to indigenize, you know, the whole concept. Cristofori. Paul. Paul, who said the quickest way of ending a war? I think it's a common statement. Ending a war is to lose it. The quickest way, you understand? So it's available in English literature. Who said the quickest way of ending a war is to lose it? And I think the statement is apt. It encapsulates
Shakespeare.
Yeah, Shakespeare did not say it, but somebody said it.
Napoleon?
No, not Napoleon. Yeah, I mean it.
Pass.
Pass quickly, you, Peru.
No idea.
Yes, John.
Winston.
George Orwell. George Orwell. Now, for 3 points, listen. Now, listen. According to curdling, listen, curdling, is the breaking of an emulsion or colloid into large parts of different composition through the physical chemical processes of flocculation, creaming and coalescence. This is the strict, you know, tedious scientific definition of curdling. Milk, on the other hand, is a nutrient-rich liquid food produced by the mammary glands of animals, of mammals. It is the primary source of nutrition for young mammals, which includes breastfed human infants before they are able to digest some food. Now there is milk that does not curdle. You understand? Another unique phenomenon in the world of knowledge. There is this milk which does not curdle. I will define milk curdling. What milk is this?
Goat.
So we mentioned goat, and goat is out. The second thing?
Llama. Llama.
The llama. That's another, but that one is out. Yes, amigo. That of pig. Variant milk. A variety of milk. Identify the mama. What did you say?
Pig.
Pig. Pig.
No. The dog milk.
Dog. John.
Giraffe.
Camel. It is the camel. The camel. Now, if you are taking a class or course in pistology, what would you be studying?
You should know the
pistology. Do you know what is pistology? I think Paul knows this. Paul,
it's me.
I thought you knew it. You forgot it.
The study of faith.
Of what?
Faith.
Faith! Faith! Now, Aminu, you see, now, listen to this one, for 3 points. Now, measurement is the numerical quantification of the attributes of an object or event. Now, it can be used to compare with other objects or events. Now, the scope and application of measurement, however, are dependent on the context and the discipline. What does a manometer measure? You should know this one. A manometer. It is
a millimeter. Understanding.
Manometer. Manometer. What does it measure? So think about so many things.
Rainfall.
Not rainfall. Oh yes.
The wind.
Wind from manometer. John.
Aye.
Dan, no. Paul.
Small objects.
Sorry?
Small objects.
No, it measures pressure. Especially gas. Pressure. Gas pressure. Manometer. Now for 3 points. Amilu. If now, in many parts of the world, black is traditionally, you know, symbolic, as it were, of a lugubrious event, like death, mourning, funerals, and so on. But it is not the universal color of mourning everywhere. What color is worn for the funeral of royals in Egypt?
Yellow.
Yellow! Go! You did before.
No, I studied colors and when people die, areas and the color they use
in that. Colors which yes, represents a particular event and so on, and the geographical area you are dealing with. Yes. In Egypt, when you're tackling the funeral of what do you call it? Royals, it is gold. Yeah? Gold. Now, animals are multicellular. They are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic. E-U-K-A-R-Y-O-T-I-C. Eukaryotic. Organisms of the kingdom animal. Animal kingdom. Kingdom animalia. All animals are motile, that is, they can move spontaneously and independently at some point in their lives. Now, name the animal that can live longest without water. You understand? So there is a tear The camera. There's a sister.
The camera.
Knock, my friend.
Camel.
Live longest without water.
The tortoise.
I did not identify that with the tortoise. And so, John.
Pass.
Yes, Paul.
The koala bear.
The koala. Look, it's not the koala. I mean,
snail.
Ah, you see, this animal is a rare animal. You don't normally find it. The kangaroo rat. It is known as the kangaroo rat. You understand? So when you search, you know, search deep into the world of knowledge, you would be able to find this. It is called the kangaroo rat. It can live longest without water. You understand? Now, for 3 points, ladies and gentlemen, the final question. Listen. Now, the toe refers to a part of the human foot with 5 toes present on each human foot. Each toe consists of 3 phalanx bones, the proximal, the middle, and the distal bones, with the exception of the big toe. What is the name, the other name for the big toe? Rather technical biological name for the big toe. Chimu.
No idea.
Okay. Yes, what do you think?
The phalanx.
No, the phalanx. Paul.
Having come across it.
Yes. Abinu.
The thumb of the leg.
It's called what?
The thumb of the leg.
I thought you were speaking
no.
Something in the language. Hallux, the hallux. H-U-A-L-U-X, end of round one.
End of the first round of the competition. Kweku Tibu Asin Nyankoma say Central Region has no point. John Awuni Zwabuga in the Pusiga District of the Upper East Region also has no point. Amidu Fuseinu Tema Community 1 has 3 points. And with 8 points, Paul Afari Minta Tutor, one point from Senior High School, Dunkwa on the fame is in the lead.
Applause in favor of the contestants. Stupendous performance, even at this stage of the competition. But we have just started the competition, it's in its nascent levels. So let's see how things unravel as we proceed with the prosecution of the remaining rounds of the competition. Round two, question one. And it is your turn for 3 points. Is it Ami?
We're still with you, Kwemu. Kwemu, we dealt with the hallux. But see, with which part of the human body would you associate the word pulmonary? Walk the water off a dog's back.
Lungs.
Of course, the lungs. Now, this one is geographical, John. In which country would you find the Negev desert?
Egypt.
Not Egypt.
Israel.
That's correct, thank you. Thank you. This one is the habitat of the animal. Which animal lives in a drain? D-R-E-Y.
Rabbit.
Second chance.
Rat.
Yes.
Squirrel.
Sorry?
Squirrel.
Squirrel lives in a drain. The squirrel lives in a drain. Now, Gulliver's Travels. Original title. Travels into the several remote nations of the world. That was the original title of the book. Gulliver's Travels. Now, it was a four-part satirical work by an Anglo-Irish author. And it was published anonymously in 1726 as Travels into several remote nations of the world. Who wrote Gulliver's Travels? Rijon. Kwaku. Who wrote Gulliver's Travels? John, you know it.
Okay.
But since John wrote me,
yeah, got a blend.
No. Gulliver's Travels. Paul.
Is it Jonathan Swift?
Jonathan Swift is here. So this one also comes to you, Paul. You see, the Order of Merit. Order of Merit. It is a Commonwealth Order of Merit which recognizes distinguished service in the armed forces, in science, in art, in literature, or for the promotion of culture. It was established in 1902 by King Edward VII. Established by King Edward VII, admission into the order remains the personal gift of its sovereign. You know, that it still remains the personal gift of the sovereign. Name the first woman to receive the Order of Merit. You know, that special award.
The Nightingale.
Sorry?
Nightingale.
Florence Nightingale! Nightingale! You see, the baboon is a medium to large-sized species of old world monkey that is found in a variety of different habitats throughout Africa and parts of Arabia. What is the scientific name of baboon? Ape. Yes, that's different. The scientific name of the baboon. Yes,
Gallus domesticus.
Oh yes, that's another 14 of them. Where did that come from? The baboon. But is a baboon a domesticus? Domesticated, as it were. Is it a domesticus? I disagree. John!
Mr. Domestica.
Now the Domesticus is in full display, you know. It's on the floor. Paul, what's on the... Don't go there.
you think that is the wrong direction. What is the name of baboon in science? You can't pass. Oh, you want to pass? You want the second part of the show? It is called... Oh, you want to give me the answer? Papu. Papu. Yes, it's not Papu. But horses. They evolved over 50 million years from many-toned animals to the big, beautiful, single-toed horses of today. The modern horses has been domesticated around the world for many reasons, including transportation and for battle, you know, warfare and so on. What is the scientific name of the horse? What is the scientific name of the horse?
Pass. No idea.
Sorry?
No idea.
Who says no idea? I'm not even calling you. That is suicide, you know.
Okay, we're starting it on
tomorrow. Oh, yes. What do you know, suicide? John!
It's a hippo.
Hippo?
Yes.
If there's no hippo for horses. Paul! You know this one?
Yes.
Her sign.
No, there's no sign. The Equus. Equus. You know, E-Q-U-U-S. The Equus Caballus. Equus, but Caballus is a horse. Equus Caballus. C-A-B-A-L-L-U-S. Now, who said again? I mean, now, we are... There are two Moscow landmarks that have played a central part in the political life of the city and the former Union of Soviet Social Republic, the USSR. Now, one of us is a triangular fortified enclosure in the center of Moscow. Now the seat of the Russian government and the center of the Russian Orthodox Church. Who are we? We are two Moscow landmarks that have played a central part in the political life of the city of the former Union of Socialist Republics. One of us is a triangular fortified enclosure in the center of Moscow. Now the seat of the Russian government and the center of the Russian Orthodox Church. Who are we? So there are two identifiable locations here. Kweku, who are we? Triangular fortified enclosure in the center of Russian seat of government, and then the center of the Russian Orthodox Church.
In the Kremlin or the Red Square.
That's correct. That's correct. The Red Square and Kremlin. Thank you, John. You see, but this one, for 3 points, listen. I am a fortified natural stronghold or citadel in ancient Greece. The Greeks built their towns in plates near or around a rocky hill that could easily be fortified and defended. Sometimes, the ruler of the town lived within the walls of my stronghold. In many cases, I became the site of temples and public buildings and thus served as the town's religious center and the focal point of its public life and as a place of refuge. Who am I?
Mount Olympus.
Look, second chance.
Athens.
Look.
Acropolis.
Acropolis. Acropolis. It is the Acropolis. Now Phobos and Deimos are moons of Mars. What do the words Phobos and Deimos mean?
Fear and terror.
Sorry?
Fear.
Fear and panic, you know. Fear and terror. It's correct. Fear and terror. Phobos
and Davis. Yes, common place words. Returning for 3 points. You see the red telephone box. This red telephone box, mm-hmm. you understand, the telephone kiosks for a public telephone, is a familiar sight in the streets of the United Kingdom. When you go to Malta, where my man belongs to, Bermuda and the Gibraltar. Now, despite a reduction in their numbers in recent years, the traditional British red telephone kiosk can still be seen in many places, you know, throughout the United Kingdom and in current or former British colonies around the world. The color red was chosen to make them what? Easy to spot, easy to identify, easy to verify, easy to see. Who designed the red box? Red telephone box. Who designed the red telephone box?
Pass. Pass it.
You always pass it before I call you. Yes, quickly.
Alexander Graham Bell.
No. Paul.
Wilson.
No. Sir Giles Gilbert Scott. Gilbert Scott. You remember the name? Gilbert Scott. Now the place of Egypt. Also called the 10 plagues, were 10 calamities that, according to the Bible book of Exodus, God inflicted upon Egypt a demonstration of power after the Pharaoh conceded to Moses' demands to let the enslaved Israelites go into the wilderness to make sacrifices. What was the fourth plague?
The water turning into, the sea turning into air.
No, that was not the fourth plague.
The mouse.
The
mouse.
The mouse.
The flies.
The flies, thank you, man. This is the nature of what he got in demonstration, in desperation. He was trying to demonstrate flies, you know, with his hands, just to play to his hands. My good master, my friend, allow me to go to the flies. The box. That's actually. But you see, if the International Dialing Code of Ghana is 233, what is the International Dialing Code for Greenland? This is a faraway question. It's a faraway question. I'm sorry.
92.
92. I don't blame you, it's not, sorry. you see, Greenland is so isolated that people, you know, do not pay attention to the events that surround this island country, you see.
97.
Look, my friend. Yes, Paul.
How many digits?
No, I don't think that would be fair for me. Here, we have 5 digits.
Okay, 111.
111. Yes. So, well, so you know the digits. Well, I mean,
no idea.
299. 299. Now, for 3 points, listen. A fathom is a unit of length in the old imperial and the United States customary systems, used especially for measuring the depth of water. Now, a fathom is 1,8288 meters. How many feet make one fathom? Chibu, how many feet make one fathom? This is the second round.
6 feet.
This is the second round. Sorry?
6 feet.
6 feet is correct. 6 feet is correct. Well, the Suez Canal is an artificial sea level waterway in Egypt. Construction of the canal began in 1859 and was completed in 1869. The starting point of the Suez Canal, the start point, is Port Said and ends at Port Tawfiq. Huh? Declare the names of the two seas.
which are joined by the Suez Canal.
The Mediterranean and the Red Sea.
It's correct. 3 points. Thank you very much. Fourth, language is the ability to acquire and use complex systems of communication, particularly the human ability to do so. And English language is my specific example of such a system. What is the most widely spoken language in the world?
Mandarin, Chinese.
Chinese is correct! Now listen, a statement of English liberties received the world seal on the 19th of June. The statement is considered the oldest constitution in the world. What is the statement called? And in which year? But I'll take out the year.
Come again.
There is the statement of English liberties, a statement, you understand, document of English liberties, which received royal approval on 19 June in a certain year. The statement is considered the oldest constitution of the world. What is the name? Last question in this round of the competition. Aminu.
Fast.
Wehu. No. Yes.
The Magna Carta.
The Magna Carta! It is the Magna Carta of 1215. Magna Carta of 1215, ladies and gentlemen, end of round two.
Kweku Tibu has 7 points. John Awuni has 8 points. And Paul Afariminta is still leading with 19 points.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, for fairness, ladies and gentlemen, we have 10 minutes to prosecute the remaining portion of this competition. 10 minutes, 10 questions. You know, for fairness, the scores are toast. Round 3, question 1. Is it? John. Now, there is a territory probably best known as the island to which a French emperor was exiled in 1815. The Zulu chief, Dine Zulu, was confined when about 6,000 Boer prisoners were held. Name this territory. Territory known as the island to which a French emperor was exiled in 1815.
Zulu chief Sicily.
No, Zulu chief Dine Zulu was confined, and about 6,000 Boer prisoners were also held. This territory, Paul.
In Saint Helena.
Saint Helena. That's right.
The question is obvious. But which French emperor was exiled?
Napoleon Bonaparte.
Napoleon Bonaparte. If the title of the king of the Gomba is Yana, what is the title of the Gonja king? If the title of the king of Dagomba is Yana, what is the title of the Gonja king?
Yabungura.
Yabungura is correct. The bond of 1844 was signed under the watch of Commander Hill. But when did the first Europeans arrive in the Gold Coast? 10 questions, 10 minutes.
1492.
Look! Yes, John!
1494.
Look! Paul!
1471.
1471! One point! The name Gold Coast was given to the country now Ghana by the Portuguese. But when did the Gold Coast become a British colony? Which year?
1804.
Look! Second chance.
1824.
Look! Your time. Aminu.
1840.
Look! Chimono.
1809.
Look! John.
1874.
1874! One point! Who was the first British governor?
The question again.
Who was the first British governor? No comments.
George McLean.
Look, second chance.
Commander Hill.
Look, your turn. Paul.
McCarthy.
Sir Charles McCarthy. One point. Paul. The old capital of Ghana, Cape Coast, was moved to Accra. Which year?
1877.
It is correct. One point. 3 points. Your turn. When was the Sagarenti War of the Ashanti fought? Anu. Sagarenti War. The Sagarenti mostly War.
1842.
Second chance.
1844.
Look. Chimu.
1895.
Look.
1874.
1874. Your turn. For 3 points. When was the Ashanti War fought? What year?
1900.
Correct. 3 points. And the final question. Four. In which year were the Ashanti defeated? In which war were the Ashanti defeated in 1826?
1826. What?
Doduwa? No, not the Battle of Doduwa.
Famina.
No, not the Battle of Famina.
The Battle of Ezamanko.
No. Yes, the final question.
The Fayasa War.
Your turn.
Go. Amando.
The Akatamanso War. End of the competition.
At the end of the final round of the competition, Kweku Tibu Aseng Jankromase in the Central Region had 7 points. Amidu Fuseini Tema Community 1 had 9 points. John Awini Zwaboga in the Putiga District of the Upper East Region had 13 points. And with 28 points, Paul Afareminta Tuta, Buaponsem Senior High School, Dunkwawan of Fame, came tops.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. The scores have been declared the second quarterfinal of the 2020 championship. Ladies and gentlemen, the personality who has emerged triumphant, who is most prominent at the end of the whole proceedings, this individual, one-time champion of what you know, a teacher from Buaponsem Senior High School, Dunkwawan of Fame, ladies and gentlemen, welcome the one and only Little Safari, Paul Afareminta. Thank you very much. Your class would want to congratulate the other contestant, John Awini Zwabunga in the Posega District of the Upper East Region, Amidu Fuseini of Tema Community 1, and of course the Kuchibu of Asein Nyankumase, ladies and gentlemen. We have come to the end of the whole assignment. But before we sign off, ladies and gentlemen, we would want to convey a certain sad message. George Bestasante, one-time champion, he is deceased. He died a few years ago. His mother, Selina Emma Enimua, has also died. We extend our commiserations to the family of Selina Emma Enimua. May her soul rest in peace. Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon all of you and grant you peace. On this note, and until the same time next week, when we bring your questions from archaeologists, zoology, on behalf of my producer, Brothers Mensa, Kinsley Abuagi, Sir Collins Mensa, Samuel Logo, Fancy Triando, Kishola Tainga, Fritz and Ovi, and the Stephen Aspark of Victoriani, Greg Mingo, William Mekosiakwa, Benue Otu, Sergina Mensa, Edward Manuel Saka Kote, and the one and only personality, the indefatigable, Kanjaga Lagatin. This is me, your quiz master, Dana Ferreira, what I'm asking you here, and those of you out there, all the aficionados, they are devotees of what you do, and what do you do?